Eustace quickly settled back down on the dark railway, feeling better than he had done for a long time. He immensely enjoyed speaking to his old friends again, and promptly discovered all that had happened during his absence.
So, Brian tells me you killed an engine, David.
Kind of.
What do you mean, kind of?
I'll admit it, I pushed that rude little twat off the cliff, but Maxon survived, so attempted murder is probably a better description of these events.
So what happened to this, sir, Maxon?
Well, he was taken away to Bristol, we believe, but a dear friend of mine says he'll be repaired and sent to Newport.
And what exactly do you three do around here?
Well, I'm used for odd jobs mainly, such as generally shunting and banking. I'm the main goods engine round here now.
And I haul expresses, passenger trains, I take the post trains. Bollocks, Alan! You're the yard shunter down at the industrial estate.
Alan rolled away looking fucking furious. A few days after Eustace's return, Dave was finally called to the works to have his firebox repaired. Eustace took him down to the junction to await the works diesel, who would then accompany him to the works.
5 weeks, Eustace! 5 bloody weeks I've been waiting for this! The system's ridiculous!
I know, David, soothed Eustace.
But you'll be back in service before you know it.
I hope so.
Oh look, here's the works diesel now!
An irritable-looking diesel approached the two engines.
I'm here to pick up a steam locomotive. XLMS Stania class number 45101. For urgent firebox repairs?
Yup, that's me!
Excellent, sir. Now, I just need you to sign this consent form.
With what? My non-existent hands?
Oh, right. Yes. Begging your pardon, let us go.
I'll see you soon, Eustace. Behave yourself while I'm gone.
Me? Misbehave? The thought of it, my dear David. Now off you go, you scallywag. Eustace worked happily for the next couple of weeks, proudly stomping up and down the line with the express, floating gleefully in good trains and shunted aside for him to pass. However, all of this fast running, plus being on standby duty at night, was taking its toll on the Bulleid Pacific.
I'm so tired. I must get some sleep.
What do you mean you're tired? You hardly do anything.
All you do is shuttle up and down the line all day. You never shunt your own trains together, because we do it for you.
That's because that is your job. If you have ever hauled an express, we could pull an express, and I dare say myself and Colin could do so much better than you.
Oh, really? Said Mr. Dark, as he emerged from the back of the shed.
Well, Colin Eddie, if you believe you can haul the express better than Sir Eustace here, then why don't you take the first service tomorrow? Eustace needs some basic general maintenance, so I think giving him the day off seems appropriate. What say you?
I don't know, sir.
Are you sure, sir? I mean, I am a Power Class 7 Pacific. These two together only make up Power Class 6.
You pompous, arrogant git!
All right, sir, me and Colin will be glad to do it.
Excellent. Well, make sure you two are ready for 7:15 tomorrow morning. Good day to you.
Early next morning, Eustace headed off to the station in order to watch Colin and Eddie's attempt to haul the express before his maintenance began. Eustace watched, bemused, as Alan and Ryan moved the heavy coaches into the platform.
Heckin' hell, these are bloody heavy!
I know, Mr. Dart told us to assemble at least 11 coaches for this train. Heavy load for Colin and Eddie to tackle.
As long as they show up that crazy, old, useless, arrogant!
I can hear you, you know, Alan.
What I meant was, shut up!
Once the train was assembled, and passengers began to board, Colin and Ellie decided it was time to get ready.
All right, Colin, go and get some coal. I'll go and wait in the station for you.
All right.
Good. Shut your face. You're not going to distract me this morning, mate.
Luck. Meanwhile, Colin had filled his bunker with coal. Now all he had to do was get back to the station and...
Oh Christ, I'm off!
Fantastic! I'd better tell the others. Colin's driver ran over to the station to explain what had happened. And so, he's blocking the yard entrance, meaning that nobody else can get out to do any work. I'm afraid you'll have to double-head with Eustace this morning, Eddie. No way! I'll do it myself! Out of my way! Eustace watched curiously as Eddie struggled and strained to get the heavy coaches moving.
Come on, you bastard! Get moving! Go on!
Unfortunately, Eddie's wheels couldn't grip the rails, and he slipped fiercely. After a good 10 minutes of this, his driver gave up. Give over, Eddie! Let's get out of the way and let Eustace take this one! What if I... No! The train is already late as it is! Let Eustace do it! He's stronger than you! Come on! Let's go find a breakdown crane or something and get Colin back on the line! Begrudgingly, Eddie was uncoupled from the train and ran into the far platform, while Eustace smugly backed onto the train. He pulled away almost effortlessly, whilst Eddie stared, furious at his failure. Eustace didn't get his maintenance that day, but nobody else had managed to get out of the shed, thanks to Colin. Eddie had failed to find the breakdown crane, also because of Colin, so Mr. Dark had brought one up from the main line that evening. Once Colin was back on the rails, he backed into the shed, where everyone jeered and grumbled about him. Eddie was angry too. Mr. Dark had told him that, most unfortunately, he'd have had to complete everyone else's work, while Eustace handled the passenger trains that day. They all arrived back in the sheds looking very grumpy. Thanks a lot, Colin! I had to bank that smug git up my bank! What a great day! It wasn't my fault I derailed! The Sigmund didn't sit the point correctly! Well, I guess that's taught us a valuable lesson. What? Huh! Probably something along the lines of, I have learned not to pick on Eustace ever again! Something like that, yes. I'm sorry the way I acted today, Eustace. You really are the strongest steam engine on the line. Damn straight! And don't you forget it! But, said Colin curiously, aren't you mad at us? You didn't get your maintenance or your day off. Never mind that. Mr. Dark has arranged to have the day off tomorrow. And anyway, I had a jolly good time watching you two flail around this morning. So no harm done, eh? Colin and Eddie privately agreed that harm had indeed been done to their reputations.